All right, everyone. It's Thursday, and let's let the cat out of the bag, because Maxie's going to have an unfamiliar voice on the pit wall, because we just stole GP. I think he's going to be the race engineer for Theo as well. But anyway, welcome along, everyone. It is Thursday. You know what that means. Welcome along to episode number, was it 14? No, 15 of our F1 Manager 24 Team Chaseliner to Glory career mode here on the Rockstar Pool 69 channel. And we're off to Belgium. The race before the summer break is the Belgian Grand Prix. If you like the content you see, do consider the like button. Also, that subscribe button as well, because it tells YouTube, oi, promoting more. Red Bull, they lead the way, followed by Ferrari, then McLaren, Mercedes, Aston Martin, RB, Williams, Chaseliner, Haas, Alpine, and Sauber bring up the rear. We're beating three teams. That's all that matters. They've got to score points to beat us. Max Verstappen does lead the Drivers' Championship, but only by 90 points now from Charles Leclerc. Then comes Carlos Sainz, Lando Norris, Sergio Perez, Oscar Piastri, Lewis Hamilton, George Russell, Alonso, and Yuki Tsunoda. Round to that, your top 10 in the fastest pit stop, we're last. Yeah, we're last. But that's okay, because I think we've found a way. Anyway, let's have a look for some... let's go... Oh. Let's take a risk with Liam. Go up P18, and we'll do the same for Theo, because no, Theo will get P18, no problem. Well, he should get P18, no problem. Okay, on to Q1, and it looks like Spa's infamous weather has showed up this weekend. So we better get out there early, we better get out there very quickly, because we need to do some runs. Fuel them for a couple of laps, and we'll go from there. Well, we should go from there anyway. Let me just check my phone before we carry on. Yes, I've had some good news come through. I've also had some meh news come through. That right there. Thank you very much. Okie dokie.
Yeah, copy that.
That's cool. What? Oh my God, Liam Lawson. Liam Lawson, ladies and gentlemen.
Bye, bad guys.
Is he damaged the... He's damaged the car. No way he makes it in. Pourchaire going purple, purple, purple. Purplebricks.com for Pourchaire. Lawson nearly a second slower. Oh, Pourchaire purple again. Aww. He went purple, then went yellow. I bet Ricardo got in the way, didn't he? He didn't even improve. He didn't even improve, nor did Pourchaire. What the hell, man? Oh, what the hell? Unbelievable. Are we going to be P20 and P21? I think we are, aren't we? It's only going to get wetter from here. And if it does, I'm going to be properly pissed. And I don't mean just properly pissed, I mean properly pissed. Excuse me. Like properly, properly angry. That's what is going to happen. I think we were a lot faster than that. And then Lawson did his floor in. And here comes bloody... Can we change that floor? We can, but... unfortunately, it means Lawson is out of the session. Would we be able to change that floor between sessions, between qualifying and practice and race? It's a yellow flag.
But
Sergeant's binned it.
There.
What are you doing,
now,
Logan?
This is what happens. They took turn eight.
He's doing that. That's what he's doing. It. And he wonders why he's out of F1.
To be doing that.
Logan Sargeant. Oh my God. Everyone was in, and then everyone's now. God's sake. Well, Pourchaire may improve. Pourchaire does improve slightly. Liam Lawson didn't improve, and that should come as no surprise to anyone. They might get a clear. No, they're not going to get a clear run, are they? Well, if you enjoyed that one, we are out of qualifying.
Just want brakes on the way in.
Unbelievable, mate. Unbelievable. But look at that smug face. Look at that face you just want to punch over again. There's a face you're like Oscar Piastri, pole position for the Belgian Grand Prix. That right there is what we are talking about, folks. Alright, the typical Belgian weather is here once again. Stuff you don't like to see. Then again, it is the Belgian weather. When don't we like to see that? Do we go two softs with Liam and hope he gets a good move, or do we not? I think... I think it might be a no, you know. Right, let me get started over here. There we go, that's that sorted. And then there's that as well. Yeah, I think going one stop medium is the way to go here. I honestly think that that is the way. I really do. I think that it's possible that we might be able to do some good with it as well. Alright then, let's go and let's go try and have a good race. Though that isn't normally what happens around these parts.
Final checks are being carried out by the teams, and it won't be long until we get this race underway. And there's always a sense of excitement when it comes to talking about Max Verstappen.
It's a promising position for them starting in P3. They'll be looking to make the most of the slipstream.
So let's see what today has in store, shall we? You can hear the excitement in the crowd here at the Belgian Grand Prix. It's lights out, and away we go.
All right then, had a bit of a toilet break. Just to calm myself down, compose myself a little after that.
See what you could do.
Well, quite frankly, shocking qualifying session that they both had. Although, to be fair, I don't think it was their fault so much. It was more the fault of other drivers that were blocking our way. So we could have been a lot higher up the field. I'll just tuck into a biscuit while I'm here. Got a custard cream. Yum, yummy. Mmm. Any of my UK viewers, custard creams are almost god tier, I would say. They're not. Certainly we would put chocolate biscuits up there. I'd certainly put chocolate malted milk up there. But custard creams have got to be up there as well, have they not? Custard creams are almost practically goat tier, I would say.
Three and four.
I would say it anyway, I don't know if anyone else would say it. But again, what I say normally doesn't mean absolute jack you know what. And we mean that. But it's fine. It is absolutely fine. Has that stream ended, by the way? No, it hasn't. It's almost about to end. Yeah, I've got Big Jet's Chicago stream on in the background. Oh, yes. We'll take that.
DRS enabled.
We will definitely be taking that, I think. Okay, DRS enabled. Now I've got my full attention on this race. Joe's got off. Oh, Joe always seems to be having a mechanical problem, doesn't he?
Super harsh
on his gears. That is one car we are not going to be beaten by today. Pourchaire overtakes Logan.
Here we go.
And that is one car that Logan is not going to beat today. Oh, nice move into La Source. Do you still get DRS off the cars in front of us? I really hope that we do. As Lawson now overtakes Sargent. So Sargent's going backwards very quickly. There seems to be a nice little five-car train here going on. With that looks like Gasly at the head of the field. We're dropping Guan Yu Zhou very, very quickly. I think we're about to drop Sargent as well, as Sonoda's binned it. Where's this? In the bus stop chicane? Yep, bye-bye. Whoa, did you see that Mercedes take a void in action? Lawson overtakes Ocon. Did you see that Mercedes take a void in action? Oh, three wide. Three wide, get toasted. You've just been chaselined. How's that feel there, Sunshine? I hope it feels good as Pourchaire now overtakes Ocon. Hold on, so did... I think Lawson overtook Pourchaire and Ocon, and now Pourchaire... Oh, he's running wide. You love to see it. Pourchaire, get the elbows out, Sunshine. Get him out and stick him out nicely. Pourchaire now overtaking Magnussen, so he's obviously overtaken Logan Sargent somewhere out there. So not Logan Sargent, Liam Lawson. Where is Liam? There he is. Having a good old fight with Ocon at the moment. That's another position for Pourchaire. As Ocon overtakes Lawson. Let's down the Kemmel straight. That was always going to happen. So we've got Gasly, Bottas, Pourchaire, Magnussen. Then we've got Lawson and Ocon. And slowly we've dropped Sargent and Zhou. Because I think the pair of them are dealing with some mechanical issues with their car. No, Sargent is not dealing with any issues with his car, as Pourchaire...
Struggle a bit with front looking, guys.
Let's crack on.
Yeah, yo! Let's take a
look at the replay.
Pourchaire has gone fucked up!
The brakes.
Speaking of...
Now they did leave.
Well, that might actually be too bad on the tyres. He might get away with that. Lawson overtakes Ocon. So now Lawson has got to be a team leader. We saw a yellow flag momentarily. Oh, get him up the inside of the bus stop. Oh, that's beautiful. That was beautiful. I think someone dived into the pit lane there. Yes, it was the Haas car of Kevin Magnussen as Pourchaire
right
overtakes Ocon.
Now
so he's recovering very nicely. Yes, we're watching the action very, very closely here with the Chaseliner. And Theo back in the groove, back in the swing of things as well. As Leclerc has a mechanical fault.
And as far as we can tell,
Leclerc, previous race winner here at Spa-Francorchamps. 2019, I believe that was, as Hülkenberg overtakes Liam Lawson. Oh, he's going outside, he's going inside. See you later. So that's the two RBs back there. Is that Sonoda and Ricciardo back there? Yeah, I don't think they're somehow our race today, unfortunately. I'd like them to be our race, but I don't think they are our race. We're struggling for some points here as Albon overtakes Pourchaire. We just got Flight Radar 24 up. See what's happening over Rugeley. We got a couple of... little guys hanging over us at the moment. Nothing too special as Albon overtakes Liam Lawson. What else we got? Yeah, we just got some Cessnas. Although we do have something coming down very quickly. Oh, Great Futures sticker. BA777. That's a nice way to Heathrow right now as Magnussen overtakes Lawson. I think the rain is on its way because we are expecting some rain. That's over Stoke-on-Trent at the moment. Wouldn't mind seeing a bit of that. Oh, it's not really a special thing, is it? It's just got a sticker at the end. There, Ocon binned it.
Let's take a closer look. Now we're watching Esteban Ocon here.
That's a shame.
Things are okay at this stage.
Actually, why am I saying it's a shame? It's not really a shame, is it? Unfortunately. It's Esteban Ocon. Ricardo has a mechanical failure now. What's going on with Ricardo? We don't know. Gasly overtakes Lawson. I think it's a case of we're holding out now for...
It's certainly inviting.
Is it blue skies out there? Oh, it's broken cloud, so we may see it, we may not see it. I'm just waiting for a triple 747 to go over my house. If a 747 decides it wants to go over my house today, it'd be nice if he did. Magnussen overtakes Pourchaire. Yeah, we're waiting for this.
And if we watch Magnussen,
we're waiting for this rain. And I think the rain is here. Which is good. Yeah, the rain's here now. So now we just got to wait for the right time to make our stop.
And that's 16th
there is a bit
now.
Of a gap forming now between Pourchaire and Lawson. I wonder.
Now we
it's a, only about
a
4 second gap
along the
as Pourchaire now goes up the inside of Kevin Magnussen. I wonder if it's worth double stacking. It'd test the pit crew nicely, wouldn't it? Ricardo has an issue at the pit stop. Yeah, I think this is the lap. If everyone's coming in for instance now, this is the lap. Sticky left rear. Give it a couple of bangs. We're sponsored by Hugo Boss, we're sponsored by Visa, we're sponsored by Cash App, we're sponsored by Orleon, we're sponsored by all the stuff that doesn't give us better pit stops over there at RB, which is useful. Yeah, there's what's the gap between the pair of them? It's about 4 seconds, is it? I'm going to double stack them. I'm going to double stack them.
Just be wary, the pit entry is slippery.
Copy.
Let's do this. I think there's enough of a gap here between the pair of them that
just come in slow.
They can do this. I have every confidence in my pit crew. We need to stop one. So there goes on the inters. Oh, that is slick. Oh, they are legends. What a bunch of legends. Wouldn't have got that at Alfa Romeo, would ya? Yeah, the girls did good. They did very good out there. Hamilton's developed a mechanical problem. What a set of pit stops. That was as slick as Hamilton and Bottas in China 2021. Absolutely love it as Zhou's now. I think that's Zhou done for the day, isn't it? Can't upshift. Uh-oh, he's going to be retiring anytime soon. You can see that coming as Ricardo has developed a mechanical failure now. The problem is I need Lawson in P18 to score, to get some money. But he's just not in P18 at the moment. He's stuck behind Pierre Gasly and can't do anything about him as Oscar Piastri develops a fault on his car. Belgium is not the place to develop faults. As finally, Lawson gets his man.
We're watching the action closely here. The gap
down the inside of Lassos as it stopped raining, maybe.
And the overtake is made.
I'd be interested if it's stopped raining. Might have to start protecting these tyres. Yeah, it's definitely stopped raining, and nobody has decided to come in for softs. We've all decided to be very stubborn out here on these intermediate tyres. Because Lord knows we can be very, very stubborn. Right, everything you got here, please, Liam.
We'll go to high fuel now.
Just don't overtake him. Oh, he's overtook him. Oh, I didn't want him to overtake him. That was not the way that that we wanted it to go today. Let's get off that. Thank you very much. And now he's Pourchaire's comfortable in P16. He's overtaken Bottas. I think he's gonna be done on the outside, isn't he? Oh, you useless sack of
Spine.
It's fine. These things are going to happen. I don't think you can catch him now either.
Just do the
He's
best
disappeared that much up the road. He just can't. He just can't catch him. As much as he wants to, and we're going to have to cut the fuel on him as well. Verstappen has won this race. We don't care if Verstappen wins, because we're getting a bit narked off with Verstappen, unfortunately, folks.
Astounding. I don't
and we're not just getting a little bit narked off, we're getting a whole lot narked like off. Because Max Verstappen is ruining this sport.
We'll catch these guys.
I said it. I said it, and I am not even sorry about saying it either. Any 747s into Birmingham International today? Ooh, which Dubai one is it? Ah, it's not the not my favourite.
How are the tyres?
Be nice if we did have a 747 into Birmingham International today. Unfortunately, it looks like it's going to be a 16 and a 19, which is, it's not good,
okay,
is it? It's not good. It doesn't look good. And I'm very unhappy about that. Got the masked 747-767 in.
Okay, checkered flag.
No 747s, unfortunately. That's a shame. I bet there's a 747 tomorrow, isn't there?
Yuki Tsunoda makes his way back after the events of that race.
Just managing a finish in the points, having crossed the line in 10.
Well, Max Verstappen can add yet another podium to his already impressive record.
And that victory takes them into double figures for the year. An incredible 10th win of the season.
And there you have it. A smiley podium lineup at the Belgian Grand Prix. Well, Karun, how do you think they'll be feeling in the team garage at the end of that?
Well, it was a bit of a mixed bag here. Some things went their way, but others didn't. I think their main target now will be finding some consistency for sure.
And that is that for this weekend's F1 action here in Belgium.
For the next round, Formula One won't be straying too far. We'll be heading to the dunes of Zandvoort and the lightning speed of the Dutch Grand Prix.
Oh, is it the Dutch Grand Prix next? Oh, there's another terrible Grand Prix for us. Terrible in every sense of the word. Because generally, it is terrible, but Verstappen wins another one. Anyone want to do their best, DJ Khaled? Another one. And another one. What's this going to be on the LH954? I'll have to check that. We didn't even get a fast pit stop. That was a slick pit stop from the crew, and they didn't even get rewarded for it. Like, you can go and suck a great, big, massive pile of donkey. And the money for the sponsors comes in free and $0.85 million. I don't think we had any mandatory activities. That's fine. Matt Harmon, who's leaving us at the end of the season, goes up to 80 rated. You're more than welcome to him. Requires response. Yay, we got Abby pulling. And it's only going to cost us $25,000 this time. This time. We will get our girl. Abby pulling, welcome to the team. Welcome to the team, Abigail. Now we're going to be cooking on natural gas. Right, let's get the sponsor plan sorted for the next 6 weeks. We'll get you. We're sending you. So goodbye. What else can we do? We could do a factory race day experience. We're not exactly doing a lot in the factory. Yeah, I don't want to send Theo for anything. No mandatory activities. So that's fine. We could do the design center. We'll send that. Yeah, I'm happy with this. If we do all that and then Do we send a race engineer for an interview? No, we've already done that. Do we do the schools event again? Yeah, head of aero's going, so yeah, that's fine. That's fine. We can do all of that. What have we got to change on the car? Just one piece of the car, and that is a suspension failure for Theo. We'll get that sorted. He'll probably... can we design this underfloor yet? Probably not. Can we design side pods? Yes. Let's design the side pods. And then get that sorted. All right then, guys. Well, thank you for watching. Hope you did enjoy that. If you did, leave a like. Don't forget to subscribe if you've not already done so. Playlists will appear all around momentarily. Go check out some more Rockstar Pool 69 content at your viewing pleasure. In the meantime, though, stay safe. Be kind to each other. You can't be kind, quiet. No place in the world you can't be kind to people. I'll see you tomorrow for the Dutch Grand Prix. And, well, if we thought Hungary was bad, Holland is our worst track. Absolutely. Which means we're going to have a banger of a race on our hands out there, aren't we now?